Hi, thank you for joining me for day 19 of 30 Days of Sketches with Christie's Beautiful Life. And today's sketch is by Hannah Panter. You can see it in the top right hand corner there. I'll leave Hannah's details in the description box down below, along with the playlist of everybody else who's joining in on this fabulous hop. So today I wanted to use my Where To Next papers, and I've chosen a photo from back in July 2014 of my daughter with an owl at the local Howley Carnival. It was fabulous. It's held in a park just around the corner from us, and she had the opportunity to hold the owl. She was really scared, but she did it, and I was so proud of her. So I've chosen this black graph paper as my border for the layout. So I'm just cutting the middle so that I've got that for another day. And then I've cut an inch off each side of the white cardstock, and that will be my base. I'm so sorry about that fly. It was really annoying me while I was scrapping. It's so hot here in the UK at the moment. We've had all the windows and doors open, and flies are becoming an issue. It does go shortly. I think it makes an appearance a couple more times and then it disappears. So I'm just distressing the edges of the white cardstock, and then I shall glue that down on the frame. I was considering stitching around, but honestly, it's so warm, I just couldn't be bothered with getting my machine out to stitch around, so I've just glued it in the end. So just running around it with my wet glue to get that stuck down, and then I can work on the square inside that the photo is going to sit on. So I pulled out this blue polka dot paper, and I think that works really nicely with the photo. So I'm just cutting that. I think I end up cutting it at 8 or 8.5 inches square. And that will form that large square that you can see in the sketch there. It was an interesting sketch to do because this isn't a style of scrapping that I normally do, but I did thoroughly enjoy it, and it's something that I will revisit in the future. Using this much pattern paper isn't usual for me, so it was quite an interesting one. But yes, as I say, I did really enjoy it. So I've pulled a couple of papers out of the 6x8 paper pad to map the photo onto, and I'm just trimming it with my scissors down the side. I'm leaving the bottom long because I'm going to tear the bottom edges, but I just wanted to get it matted first before doing that. So I'm offsetting the second mat, the green mat, against this one, and then again I'll trim down the side. And then I can tear the bottoms off. It just gives me more control doing it afterwards. So now they're done, I'm going to distress the edges of the paper, of course, doing it retrospectively, so I have to manipulate things a little bit to get that done, but it's fine. Just pulling things back a little bit. Using that Sticks 2 tape runner is great because it's semi-permanent at the beginning, so you are able to move things if you need to. So just checking that I'm happy with the colours and the size of that photo before I work on this blue square and get that stuck down. So again, just distressing all the edges with my Tim Holtz edge distresser, and then I can get that stuck down onto the layout and get the photo on and then start embellishing. So I feel that Hannah has left her sketch open to interpretation somewhat with the sketchy bits that she's got there. I've taken that to be embellishments. I haven't quite followed as she has it, but more or less. It could have also been mixed media, but because I'm using this pattern paper, I didn't really want to come in with more mixed media at this point. So I'm just going to stick that down, add the photo, and then, as I say, I can start embellishing. I've pulled out this huge chipboard title from the chipboard pieces as well and want to use that. I absolutely adore these. You will have seen me using one a couple of days ago. And I honestly want another packet of the chipboard just so that I can use some more of these. They're fabulous. They really make a statement on the layout. So just getting the photo adhered down. And then I turn over one of the papers from the 6x8 pad that I've used previously and see the umbrella pattern on it. This one here. And I think I want to use circular elements on this layout. So I start cutting a few of these out. I go for a red one, a blue one, and a yellow one, all in differing sizes, just using my fingernails to distress the edges. And then I'm going to layer those down the bottom right hand corner. And this is where I suddenly get my idea that I want to carry that circular shape all the way down the right hand side of the photo, focusing more on that bottom right hand corner. So I've just pulled out one of my flair badges that says Embrace Life, which is perfect, and a canvas flair at the bottom that says Love. These are both from Hey Little Magpie, my website. And then this rosette, I'm just going to cut the ribbons off so that it is another circular element. And that says love this, so I think that works nicely in that right hand side there. Now I'm pulling out the paper clips from this collection. These are fabulous. You've got some acetate ones and some cardstock ones. And I'm just playing around with the different ones here. I did like this heart, and it doesn't actually make the grade in the end. I decided on something else. And then I liked this acetate camera one as well, but once again, in the end, I replace it with other things. But it's nice to have a play around. But I do settle on a little star one that I'm just putting on, well, I'm going to put on shortly, and this circular cardboard one. So the star at the moment, I put up the top there. It does move around to the side shortly. But that circular green one works really nicely with the circular elements that I've got going on. So this blue sticker that says noted is from the 6x12 sticker sheet. And I've just layered that underneath this flare badge, and then I'm adding a tangle of green thread underneath the flare just to provide a different texture. So using my wet glue to add a huge blob of glue and then get that stuck down. And then the love this is going to be mounted up onto foam pads. I just wanted to create different heights as these go up the page here. So just gluing down the other ones. That one's gluing flat. The blue one I'll add some foam pads to. And then the yellow one will be glued flat onto the layout as well. So as I say, just creating all different heights and dimensions on the page. And of course the flare are different heights as well. So that works nicely. Just trying to work out whether to glue this paperclip down or not, but I decide it's probably best to. And then I add a little heart accent from the 6x12 sticker sheet. Next I see this yellow sun, and I really want to bring this in. So I add it up to the top right hand side as well. And again, it's another circle, carrying on those circles right the way up the page. This is where I move that star acetate paper clip to the right hand side. You almost can't see it, but it definitely adds something to the layout. And then I see these orange butterflies, and as she's outside, I think they will work really nicely. So just adding those in amongst the other bits and pieces that I've added to the layout, and I end up bringing three in. And also some stars. Here's the third one that's just going in there. And then the two of these arrows, one at the top here, and then another one underneath the title, this. So just finding the place for it. And then adding this one under here. So now going into the chipboard sheet to see what I can find here, and straight away I see this word phrase that says new things to see and do. And that is so true, because she certainly hadn't held an owl before. And then some of the little gold dots, which just add a nice accent in amongst those bits and pieces that I've got going up the right hand side of the photo. This piece says memories, and it's a little arrow, so I layer that up with the arrow that's underneath the title. I like how that looks. And then this little dot that just says yes. So this sticker that I'm putting up the top left hand corner there, the So Good, is from the 6x12 sticker sheet. And now I'm going to go in with my journaling. So just using my T-square ruler to draw my guidelines like I usually do if you've watched me before. And then adding the journaling, and then my roller date stamp for my date. And the journaling just reads, we headed over to the Howley Carnival at the park around the corner, and you had the opportunity to hold an owl. You were nervous, but did it anyway. So these tickets are from the papier-y paper pack. I've just cut it in half because there was no point in hiding the other half underneath the layout. I can use that on a future layout. Same with this blue one. And this is just building up something on the left hand side of the photo. I felt it like it was very heavy on the right hand side, so I just wanted to add a little bit of something here on the left. Not too much, because I don't want it to be too cluttered. There's already quite a lot going on here. But that just sort of gives somewhere to rest the eye, really. And then this fabulous border piece I'm just tucking underneath the torn papers. And it's like a notebook piece. So I cut off the excess, and then I'm just going to glue this down with my wet glue. And in fact, looking at the layout now, most of that does get covered because I do, as I usually do, keep adding and adding little bits and pieces here and there. But it's there, and you can see it peeking out. So just repositioning that butterfly. Trying to remember where it went. And then I find this word strip. And one of the phrases is take a deep breath and enjoy this. And I thought that was so true. I was so proud of her because she has her anxieties, but she overcame them to hold this bird. And it was fabulous. So just running a bead of glue along the bottom there, and then I can stick that down. It's very thin paper in the papier paper pieces, so just being careful not to add too much so that it wrinkles. And then I find this washi tape bulldog clip, so I want to add that to the top of the page. It's just ever so slightly too tall, so I just fold the very top of it over the top of the page, and that's fine. You can see just there. So repositioning that, so good. Sticker. And then I'm coming in now with some of the little embroidered flowers that we sell at Halo Magpie in our bits and pieces. And these are just adding again a different texture and bringing in some colours that are around the page. And they just work really nicely to fill in some gaps, along with a wooden monstera leaf, again in the bits and pieces at Halo Magpie. This little camera is from the 6x12 sticker sheet. I think it's going to go at the top there at first, but I want to keep that nice and clear, so I end up putting it at the bottom next to that golden flower. And finally, I'm going to come in with some paint splatters using my gold watercolour paint. And that's more or less it. So thank you so much for joining me. I really hope you've enjoyed this. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Thanks to Hannah for the inspiration. And I shall see you again tomorrow for day 20. Thanks again. Bye.